composer friend of mine who spent some time in a mental rehabilitation center was encouraged to do a good deal of bridge playing. After one game, his partner was criticizing his play of an ace on a trick which had already been won. My friend stood up and said, "If you think I came to the loony bin to learn to play bridge, you're crazy."
Artists talk a lot about freedom. So, recalling the expression, free as a bird, Morton Feldman went to a park one day and spent some time watching our feathered friends. When he came back, he said, "You know, they're not free. They're fighting over bits of food."
Afterward, and told me that something marvelous had happened. I said, "What?" She said, "One of the music majors is thinking for the first time in her life." Then at dinner, it had been an afternoon concert, the head of the music department told me that as he was leaving the concert hall, three of his students called, saying, "Come over here." He went over. "What is it?" he said. One of the girls said, "Listen."
Coming back from an all-eyes concert we'd attended in Connecticut, Mina Lederman said that by separating his insurance business from composition of music as completely as day is separated from night, Ives paid full respect to the American assumption that the artist has no place in society. When Mother first heard my percussion quartet years ago in Santa Monica, she said, "I enjoyed it, but where are you going to put it?" But music is, or was at one time, America's sixth largest industry, above or below steel. I don't remember which. Schoenberg used to say that the movie composers knew the business very well. Once he asked those in the class who had intended to become professional musicians to put up their hands, no one did. Uncle Walter insisted when he married her that Aunt Marge, who was a contralto, should give up her career. My bet is that the phenomenal prices paid for paintings in New York at the present time have less to do with art and more to do with business. The lady who lived next door in Santa Monica told me the painting she had in her dining room was worth lots of money. She mentioned an astronomical sum. I said, "How do you know?" She said she'd seen a small painting worth a certain amount, measured it, measured hers, which was much larger, multiplied, and that was that.
30 minutes long. A few were longer. For each one, I prepared a talk about the music which was to be heard. This was necessary because most of the people there had a German point of view. And the music I was presenting was French. Satie had little fondness for German music. He told Debussy, for instance, though it was needed was a music without any sauerkraut in it.
Just the other day, I went to the dentist. Over the radio, they said it was the hottest day of the year. However, I was wearing a jacket. Because going to a doctor has always struck me as a somewhat formal occasion. In the midst of his work, Dr. Heyman stopped and said, Zen, they say,
if something is boring, after two minutes, try it for four. If still boring, try it for eight.
Try it for eight. 16,
32,
and so on.
Eventually, one discovers that it's not boring at all, but very interesting.